Lord, we just ask that all that is said and done tonight would be glorifying to you. In the name of Christ, we pray.
Against you, you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. like a cloud your sins. Return to me, for I have redeemed you.
There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus.
God promises life.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
And this is the promise he has promised us.
Eternal life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live. The gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
God promises to be with us.
The Lord your God, he is the one who goes with you.
He will not leave you nor forsake you.
I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand.
You, Lord, have not forsaken those who seek you.
Great peace have those who love your law, and nothing causes them to stumble.
Thank you.
together, children. Walk together, children. Walk together, children. Don't you get weary, there's a great camp meeting in the promised land. I said, walk together, children.
Don't you get weary.
Walk together, children.
Don't you get weary.
Walk together, children.
Don't you get weary, there's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
Holding high like a candle in the night.
So when you hear, there you go. If you could sit right here, that'd be wonderful. Yeah, right over here, this would be great. Yeah. There you go. Two more coming from that side. Very nice. And as they're coming, I have a question for you to consider. Which do you think would last longer if I were to take this paper wad and put it out into the rain and the snow and put it outside, right? So I have that paper wad, or how about this rock right here? Which do you think would last longer so we put them out in the weather? What do you think?
The rock.
The rock. I think you're absolutely right. You think he's right? Yeah, he got that one right. He gave a fist bump on that, and I think he deserved that. Very good. The rock would last a lot longer, wouldn't it? And you know, in the Old Testament, they used to use this idea because what they do if something important happened, if God did a miracle or something like that, they would pile up a bunch of rocks. And then maybe 100 years later, when they're walking through that field, a kid might say to his dad, "Hey, man, there's some rocks. What do you think those rocks mean?" And the dad say, "Oh, you know what? I think that was the time when they crossed over the Jordan and they the water stopped and God did a miracle and we could cross the river and get away from her and cross over into the promised land," right? So that's how rocks were used. So tonight we're going to try to build a little bit of an altar and we're going to play a little game. We're going to see if we can have a character say some things and we need to try to guess who that character is from the Bible. Okay, so you pay attention when someone comes up and talks about adults, you need to pay attention to, because if they don't get it, we're going to you, okay? And Pastor, you pay attention, because if they don't get it, we're going to you. We're warning them. Okay, so here we go. Now let's sing about remembering. Oh,
Yeah, Abraham, and his wife's name was?
Sarah.
Right. Yeah, Sarah, that is right. Very good. God said he would provide a son for them, and through that son, many generations later, came Jesus. Let's get some people over here. You two want to come help put this rock down? Bring it way over here, and can you put it? Yeah, we'll put it right on top of it. All right, very good. All right, say the same about that.
Necessarily know how to really study it and just look at context and history. I have really experienced just like a really solid community of people who really care about me and about each other.
Years down the road, I wouldn't want to forget the friendships I formed here because I couldn't ask for better friends that I have here.
Being here with people that are at the same stage of life as you and asking some of the same exact questions and having conversations is just really helpful to grow.
I didn't really have like a good solid foundation of like, this is what I believe and this is why I believe it before coming to Rosedale. I was kind of more like, this is what my parents believe, so I'm gonna believe it. And so after coming to Rosedale, I'm able to like really challenge my beliefs and be like, okay, why do I believe what I believe?
Matthew Cordella Bontrager, an instructor here at the college, said this time can be kind of like a retreat. And he talked about how we view that in sort of a negative light. And really, it's actually a positive thing. It's a thing armies do to kind of re-strategize to go out and prepare for battle when the enemy comes. And I think that for me, that's really been an accurate description of my whole spiritual experience here at Rosedale, as this time has been a really amazing retreat for me to just kind of regather and refocus my life and relationship with Christ so that when I go back into the world, that I can be prepared and ready to face the challenges.
The environment at Rosedale is amazing. I feel like I'm constantly doing something that matters. That's where I've actually seen growth in my life, to have like a steadiness in a schedule, in the professors, in beliefs. It's really impacted me in a way that just keeps me wanting to follow Jesus all the more. I just love my Jesus.
Rosedale came at just the right time in my life for me to just kind of build on my relationship with God. 10 years from now, when I look back at it, I'll be looking back at a time where I think God just cultivated a lot that was in my heart for him to really make it bloom and start getting that growth and start pushing me towards my calling for him. My time at Rosedale has really helped direct me in that.
this year yet. So a small ensemble that does programs in churches, and I did enjoy hearing a little bit from them tonight. I just want to take a moment to first of all say thank you so much for allowing us to come again, and for the kind hospitality we've received. And it's just been a pleasure to be here among you and with you. And I just want to say thank you for allowing that to happen. Also wanted to say we have a booth in the back that you can stop by on the way out, check out some literature from Roosevelt Bible College. If you'd like to sign up for a CD of the chorale program that we're doing tonight, we'll be recording that on Monday and producing that and putting it out as a CD. There's a place you can sign up for that, or there's some previous year CDs available for purchase also with some good choral music on it. So you might want to pay attention to that. And of course, we have a website, rosedale.edu, and just invite you to go to that and check out what's happening. We have lots of programming that goes on. We study the Bible a lot at Rosedale. We have other courses too. So just invite you to be aware of that. Point people to Rosedale for us if you could. We appreciate that very much. Now we're going to sing a song about a chair.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna,
suffering and the death and the darkness that resulted, and then the resurrection on Sunday morning. And we would like to kind of walk through that week with you now musically. If you could join us in the court that you'll find based on Isaiah 53, if you can turn in the programs and let's read this together. But he was pierced for our transgressions.
He was crushed for our iniquities.
The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed.
We all like sheep have gone astray.
Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord
teachers to integrate. Let's stand together as we sing. Go.
Jesus fled and died for me.
to come up and join us as we sing Lloyd Kaufman's arrangement of Abide With Me at Disney. Is there anyone here who falls in that category? Lead us in worship. As we get ready to kind of conclude this time, just a couple kind of closing comments. If you would like to support Rosedale and the mission that God has put before them, there are plates at the back of our sanctuary. You can simply put your offering into that offering plate. If it is a check form, I just ask that you write it out to Rosedale Bible College. If you've already made it out to Pleasant View, we'll figure it out. Okay. Also, in the back is going to be this box. They will be recycling the program, so if you'd like to keep the program, I think you're probably more than welcome to. Or if you'd like someone else to use it, that would be great too. So this will be in the back. As we think about this week, the Holy Week, and some of the travels yet before the choir, let's sing before the Lord one last time. I'm going to ask a blessing on the choir as they continue to travel. When do you guys wrap this up? I didn't ask you that. I was
Easter Sunday morning is our last one.
Okay. All right. So some good things to look ahead to. Certainly some powerful songs to sing that and share. Let's come before the Lord one last time and we'll ask a blessing on the crowd. Heavenly Father, thank you for the gifts that you've given and for the ways in which they've been developed and displayed here tonight. Lord, I imagine you smiling as you look down and you listen. Lord, I would just ask that you continue to go before the crowd, guide them, grant them safety as they continue to Thursday night and Friday night and then Sunday morning. Lord, let us not forget that it is you who receive all glory and honor. You are the one who is worthy now and forevermore. Lord, we ask a blessing not only on the crowd, but the people who have gathered here tonight. Lord, may we be vessels that speak of your glories, not just in this space, but everywhere we go. Father, this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ and all the people.